Now, if you're a fan of a day out at the races, you'll know there's nothing more disappointing than getting your glad rags on and then finding out the poor track conditions of canned racing.
But at Ellerslie Racecourse, they've been slowly digging away for years to create a racing surface unlike anything else in New Zealand. Here's Lucas de Jong. I am flesh
and I am bone riser. It's Auckland's historic home of thoroughbred racing. And while human grandstanding often gains a lot of attention, it's on the track where the real action happens.
He's hanging tough. Sounders trying to get up and won't get there. Roger that.
But it's Auckland, so wet weather sometimes gets in the way of a good race.
You know, even in the summer you can get downpour sometimes and it end up being races being abandoned.
Once the soil swells, it holds the water like a sponge. You're walking on it, you see it coming up, you can hear it bubbling. It just turns to crap straight away, and that's for every racetrack in New Zealand.
At Ellerslie, a $50 million makeover has been slowly levelling the playing field.
One of our goals is to create the best racing surface that we possibly can, and you know, we did a lot of research in the major racing jurisdictions around the world.
They've dug it out, laid 15,000 tonnes of gravel, then twice that amount of sand, before adding the secret ingredient.
Here's the profile of the track. We've got the plastic mesh, or the reflex mesh that sits in here.
That helps binds all the roots in, does it?
Binds the roots.
It's called Strathia Turf, and uses a synthetic mesh in the track's top layers.
This is the magic ingredient, isn't it? If I hold that in together like that, it's back again.
That's right. I mean, the sand will make it look like it's quite compact, but if we had a truck parked out on here, within 12 hours, it's just going to bring it back up again.
I bet you don't let many trucks park out on there.
There won't be any trucks parked out here. I probably won't drive on it myself. So that's, you know, we didn't drive on the old track. Be buggered if I'm going to let anyone driving on this one.
It'll create a durable layer that'll bounce back quickly, while the sand underneath sends Auckland's monsoon rain down the drain.
As you can see, we've just had a downpour here 2 minutes ago, and there's no water on it, but the outer surface is not on the racing track proper. You can see the water pooling.
The downpours that we had Auckland anniversary weekend, this place was the only dry spot in Auckland, I think.
All that water goes straight into Ellerslie's newest 9 metre deep wetland.
With the sand profile track, it's going to need to have a lot more water, so we did need to create a pond of some significance to store that water.
Hot or cold, wet or dry, this is about creating a track that'll keep the gates open.
Resilience is a brilliant word, and that's one of the things we're building, resilience into the track, which is great for the punters, great for the trainers as well. When the horse's hoof hits the turf, this is going to take a lot of that concussion. Yeah, so you won't be able to come to us and say your track's too
hard.
Sean's raced horses on every major track in Aotearoa. For him, this is about creating a track that's world-class.
For me as a trainer, it's just going to be consistency to bring your horses here that you're going to get a really great surface we've never experienced it before. So it's new to us, and it'll be just good to get out there and show up to the general sort of training fraternities.
When you talk about that term level playing field, this is the level playing field, isn't it?
Well, that's what we are creating, and it's to be absolutely positive that we are trying to eliminate as much as we can from any bias created, and safety, of course, which is paramount in horse racing.
Early growth is going well, but it'll be a while before our finest thoroughbreds test it out.
But we want our real big grand opening be crack a million 2024. The eyes of the world will be on Ellerslie, so all going well. Let's hope we can do it.